I'm Mr. B, and today we're talking about refrigerant identification. And I've got this MasterCool R134A equipped identifier, and I'm going to go ahead and open up this box. This box has not been opened yet, and we're going to show you what comes inside it. And also, I'm going to show you how to use it on our Danger Ranger back here. So if you're not familiar with my channel, give me a like, give me a subscribe. I'm doing more and more tool stuff on how to use these tools and what I feel is the better tools to use in the industry. So this identifier right here is one of the cheapest ones on the market. I'll put the link in the description below on Amazon so you can kind of see what the price is on Amazon. But the part number is 69134-A. As a MasterCool part number, that's for this part right here. And I'm going to take you into my classroom, and because I have a little bit better lighting than I do out there, and I'll show you what we have in this box, and then we're gonna put this on the car. I'm gonna show you how it works. So stick around. Okay, so it comes in this cardboard box here. We'll go ahead and peel the shrink wrap off of it here, and we can see what we get. All right, so here's our operation manual here. This is, let's see, just some bubble wrap here to keep this mini ID. I guess that would be identifier. This is gonna be your cord going to it, your power cord. And here is your connector there. And of course, the main unit here. Kind of the industry standard right now. This is not the most expensive identifier out there by any stretch of the imagination, but it is one that works really well. It's kind of about the size of a good size multimeter. So this has got a stand here that you can sit up on a car or whatnot when you're trying to pay attention. This thing's pretty simple too. And you'll see once you read the instructions, which is on this is not very long. Looks like the instructions come in just English and does have pictures, does have a troubleshooting section here, specifications, so it tests up to 95%. And of course, your warranty information right there. It's got some do's and don'ts. There you go. I'm sure you can find any of this information on the website. So here is your electrical. This is what hooks to the battery of the vehicle. So you have to have a good battery in your vehicle for this to work, I'm sure, to give it a good 12 volts. This is going to plug into the machine right here. And you have your testing bulb there. And this is zip tied together. I'll have to get something to pop that zip tie off right here. And let's go out to the car and see how this thing works. Okay, so first thing we're gonna do is hook the red and the black cables up. Go ahead and do that. And you'll see these lights kind of chase each other around, and that's just testing to make sure that the lights are okay. I'm gonna go ahead and press next. Okay, and it's gonna start warming up. All right, so it takes a little time. I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward through this, but I don't have my sample line set on the car yet. It's just resting on there, but you're gonna, when it starts analyzing is when you're gonna add the refrigerant to it. So let's go ahead and fast forward through this warm up. It takes about 90 seconds or so for the warm up to happen. So we're gonna go ahead and fast forward through that. Okay, when the calibrating light is going to illuminate now and flash, you're gonna need to squeeze this button 5 times, okay? Squeeze this bulb right here, just like you're doing blood pressure. 3, 4, 5, and then you're going to press next, okay? And it's gonna go ahead and start its calibration. It's gonna take about 60 seconds, so we're gonna fast forward through that to the next part of the video. Okay, after the analyzing button starts to flash, we're gonna connect our low side. We're gonna screw in the screw. And then we are going to press the next button. And again, this takes approximately 45 seconds or so. So we'll go ahead and fast forward through that as well. I don't wanna sit here and just look at this thing for 45 seconds. So, but this should come up and tell us what we've got going on, whether it's gonna be pass or fail, excess air, so on and so forth. Okay, so it's gonna give us a pass, and that is telling me that the car is at least 95% pure with 134A, so that's good. So after that, all we have to do is disconnect the sample hose, press the next button, and squeeze the calibration bulb 5 times. So we'll go ahead and disconnect this, which is kind of off screen, but press the next button, and then we're gonna squeeze 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then after that, we can disconnect it from the battery and put it back where it belongs. Okay, everybody, that does it for, again, if you're looking at buying this tool, I've tried to go over and kind of show you how to use it and also give a little unboxing and show you what all comes with it. But for the most part, it's a pretty standard tool for a pretty standard job. You know, this identification is becoming more and more important with the advent of 1234YF and some other refrigerants that we're seeing out there that can maybe get into these 134A vehicles and cause some damage to our machines and our equipment. So definitely is something I would go ahead and pick up if you've got a chance to, if you've got a little bit of extra money. It does cost a lot comparative to a couple other things that you could get, but it's a lot cheaper than these identifiers were. Some of these identifiers are, you know, $3,000-$4,000 when they first come out. This is a fraction of that. So I'll put the link down there in the description for this machine. I'll also try to add some more videos coming up soon of more equipment reviews and how-tos. So if you got a chance, give me a like, give me a subscribe. I'm also on Facebook, I'm on VK, I'm on Twitter, I'm on Instagram, I'm everywhere that everybody else is, and you just look up, I'll be there. So from now, we're done. Go ahead and have a good rest of the day, and we'll see you next time.